If your Mackie HR624 monitor speakers are no longer powering up, there is a fix for this, but it's going to require a little bit of effort on your part to open up the back and replace the one component that's gone bad. Again, this is for the Mackie HR624 monitor speakers. Here's a look at the tools you're going to need. Phillips head screwdriver, a T20 Torx star bit, an Allen wrench, very tiny little, itsy-bitsy little Allen wrench. Some heatsink grease if you'd like to replenish the heatsink grease that's in there and probably all dried into a powder. Solder suction device and some various pliers and wire cutters, and of course soldering iron and some solder would be good. The main component is a capacitor. The capacitor is an 80 volts 4.7 microfarad capacitor. If you want to replace it with a higher temp capacitor or a higher voltage capacitor, say 100 volts and 85 Celsius, that would be okay. Just make sure you don't go down in voltage or down in temperature to the next lower rated capacitor. That would definitely cause you a lot of problems. This is what the replacement looks like from Mauser. First thing you have to do is remove 1, 2, 3, 4, 8 of these Torx screws out of the outside of the case that attach it to the wooden portion of the speaker. Once you get these things removed, then the entire amplifier section should come right off the back of the speaker. Once you get these Torx screws down here all removed from the case all the way around, then you can gently lift this device and search for the wires that come up the side. Tilt it so that those wires are not pulled or damaged in any way. And then you can pull these wires away from the board. This is a simple friction pull connector here. And this one has a little button on top you push and pull out. Loosen the tie down straps that hold the wires we just disconnected. They're just some metal strap ties there. And now we can pull the entire unit off the speaker. The capacitor in question is actually buried back here behind this ribbon cable, this cable that comes out of this giant coil. So we're going to loosen up these wire ties as well. Got a little push tab on the back of this connector. Push it. Pull the connector out of the way. Let's get a little light back there. All right. Capacitor in question is capacitor number 3 here. That capacitor right there is the one that's gone bad, and it's the one that's keeping the unit from powering up. So what we're going to do to make life easier on ourselves is remove all the screws on the side and the back of this unit. There's a screw on each side, on one of this side, one on the other side, and then there's 8 screws on the back here. They're just Phillips screws. We need to pull all these screws out. We also need to remove this screw here, which holds down the coil. The next most interesting part requires this tiny little Allen wrench, and it removes these tiny little screws that hold the back control panel on. So altogether, we've pulled 10 of these screws out now. These screws that hold the back panel on, and the last one that we have left is the coil screw here. Now we're going to pull that off by putting a wrench on this nut and a screwdriver on this side. So now we've got everything loose. We took this last nut out. We can lay it on its side and gently pull everything out. A little bit of muscle. This is where you want to renew the heatsink grease. Once you get the amplifier pulled out of its housing, just squirt a little bit of heatsink grease inside here to renew it. It's not really critical to get it all spread out and everything, because this is not a processor for a computer. It's just there to help make it a little more efficient. We can see from this side, this is the one that needs to be desoldered. All right, that's the rear of the unit. The coil was here, and it's the third capacitor in. It's this small one right here. All right, I've gotten the offending capacitor out. It didn't come out easy. I had to just rip it off the board and then use a soldering iron to remove the stubs out of the board. All right, there's the new capacitor in there, and we've begun to put the unit back together. Be sure you tuck these cables back into their holders. You don't want to have your nice low bass notes being offended by rattling wires of any kind. So be sure you use these to put the wires back in where they go. Now, you remember that heat sink grease we put on there? Be sure you put these bottom screws in first to pull that heat sink down against the case and to smash that grease nice and flat. And then put the side screw in to secure the back panel. That way this side screw does not hinder the seating of the heat sink against this back side of the case. You know, while you got this thing open, you might as well go ahead and check these screws that hold this this reflex speaker in. Go ahead and check these screws and make sure they're snug. You never know, they might have gotten a little bit loose over time. Once you get it all back together, you hook up your power, press your button out, and look at that, the power comes back on again. Yay!